The effect of coronavirus has left our communities in shock. Not too long ago, we woke up one morning and the new word in town was Brexit. Not anymore, now it's Corona. A flu-like illness that attacks the lungs like Concord just about to take off. Within weeks, there was lockdown and restriction of movement called social isolation. The killer disease affects people who are between the ages of 60 and above, especially those with underlying medical health issues, including young people, even if you are of good health. There is roughly more than 1 million Sierra Leoneans living in the UK, and the majority of that population lives in Southwark, which records the highest number of COVID-19 cases in the whole of London. As a community, a team of Sierra Leoneans in South London decided to form a COVID-19 response team that comprises of individuals from various walks of life, coordinated by the Health Show Partnership, Diaspora Voices, and Sierra Gem Media, where Isita Sise Jalo is the main coordinator, assisted by Harriet Matia.
So, as you know, we're the Sierra Leone UK COVID-19 Rapid Response Team. My name is Isita Sise Jalo, and I'm in partnership with Diaspora Voices and Sierra Gem Media T-Boys Production. We put a team together with lots of volunteers, lots of people in our Sierra Leonean community who are doing different shopping, and we're putting them together for the elderly who have been told to self-isolate for 12 weeks, as well as anyone who is in the vulnerable group. For example, people who are immunosuppressed, and also people who have been isolated for 14 days, who don't have access to food, or who don't have people who can get them food and take it to their house. So as you can see, we've got lots of stuff, and some of these I've donated. Some we have to shop ourselves from the money that is being donated by others. Lots of donations. We are thanking everyone. We've got all sorts, a variety of everything. I've got stuff for babies. I've got stuff for women, you know, toiletries, snacks, even Pampers, and so on and so forth. So this weekend we're doing the deliveries, and that would also include hot meals. So we'll be delivering hot meals on top of these basic essentials and water.
Well, it's just to give support to our elderly, our vulnerable people that are isolated at home. We didn't know that we'd have lots of people that need help until the past 3 weeks. And I want to say thank you to the team. Thank you to everybody who's been supporting us financially, morally, socially, calling us, giving us thumb ups on Facebook. So I just want to ask each and every Sierra Leonean to come on board to help so that we can make it a better future for the sick people at home.
As few of the members converge at the Command Center 1 in Southwark, by putting together the packages of some of the distribution items for this week's delivery.
As we know, we all depend on the UK lockdown, and Sierra Leone Community UK and our Rapid Response Team, and we've been championing this for the last few weeks now, and this is week 3. We've been delivering not just on weekends, in between the week as well, but the Saturdays, everybody is kind of off, and we get the energy, and we don't rendezvous at the first location. We now Isata Sise Jalo in house. That's where we collect the first lot of stuff to go out to the families. Then we get for benefit on today's delivery. And for obvious reasons and for confidentiality, we not a reveal, but we got various locations in South London where they can go out, and as well as East London as well, where they go out. Myself, Golfer, DJ Ish, T-Boy, Mr. Jalo himself, and then Isata, obviously, and then other people are going to be meeting at Auntie Harriet's in location. So everybody's coming around. And the project is easy, really. It's just that UNA, where they support with indirectly or directly, either through UNA donations them financially, or the shopping they own that they do, the shopping, the cooking they own that they do, We want to say massive, massive thank you to Una, because Una, they make we able for do what they do so possible. And if Una keep the do what Una, they do so for we, it's we go able for deliver for those who are definitely in need of it.
Command Center 2 is where the entire distribution team meet and other items are put together for final distribution.
Sierra Leone Rapid Response Team, don't come on again today, as we do last weekend. So today, me on area where they cover, they go in East Street. So I get for do two deliveries. So now East Street, I they go.
As soon as you see, we don't collect we own deliveries them, and now go with the goes on out to various locations them to go do deliveries to various people. So we just they appeal to the community, if you can reach out to we whichever donation where you get, whatever little amount, whatever thing you get, just reach out to we and the team, the cable pick them up, and then distribute them to various people. Thank you very much.
I'm covering Lewisham, Deptford, and Greenwich. To be honest enough, I live on the main Creekside Road, which when it comes to 7 o'clock, I hardly see people walking around, which is, I think the community are doing very well in keeping the order.
At the moment it's really going well. People are very interactive. They're asking for help, and privately I message them and I give them the help that they require. And on Facebook at the moment, I'm just sharing ideas and ways that people can keep their kids busy. I think it hasn't really sunk in yet that they're actually not on holiday and they actually have to study. But a lot of them are getting on with it. I mean, it's difficult for schools, especially us as teachers, to try to keep them engaged in online education. So at the moment, we're all trying to learn this new system and we all just have to get on with it.
Has it been challenging for you as well?
Very, very, because my daughter also has to use my laptop. I have to use my laptop. So at the moment, we're all trying to make sure that we're all getting our work done. But, you know, at home, she's getting on with the work. She loves what she's doing. And I set the work for my students. I interact with them online. And it's going well so far.
So what does it feel like to be schooling from home? And as a teacher, you're teaching from home. And you're interacting with all those kids at the same time.
It's so strange. Because even the materials that we're providing, sometimes I have to read it like 5 times to make sure that it's appropriate and they can access it at home. So at the moment, it's difficult for everyone.
So what would be your advice to parents?
Just keep going, just make sure that you're checking on the work that is set for your kids, and then you're making sure that they're actually doing it, because they can tell you that they've done it. And actually one of the problems I have come across is them submitting the work online. A lot of them are finding it difficult. So, I mean, if you're having difficulties in that sense, please make sure you contact the school and ask the school how your kids can submit their work online.
As we now head towards East London to deliver our packages to those who are in self-isolation or of age, meaning they are not allowed out of their house for 12 weeks, it gives me the pleasure to be able to see firsthand the amount of work put together by COVID-19 SL UK response team.
My opinion would be quite subjective, because I think everybody will think they're doing their best, but I think us as a community, as in us that have come together, we are taking it seriously, because some of us are frontline workers, so we see this day in, day out. We know the reality of what's happening. We know the reality of this infectious disease and how serious it can become when it goes to the extreme. So we are taking it seriously, and that's why by taking it seriously, we're encouraging people to stay at home, and we're giving them that opportunity to stay at home by being able to supply them with their basic essentials, including hot food and water.
Monetary or basic essentials are most welcome in support of this team for the next 12 crucial weeks. And we also thank all those that have donated and look forward to more, as we have just gone through week 3 of social isolation and distancing.
That's a donation from Rebel Chic Closet. And thank you for coming. And this is a donation.
Volunteers are most welcome. For CRGM Media UK, I am Maxwell Cole.